Hey Capricorn, welcome to Queen Airbender Tarot. Today we are going to do your second week of September general love reading. Now keep in mind this is a general reading, which means it cannot possibly apply to every single person that is watching. But if you would like a personal reading, all of the information will be left in the description box below. In case you are new to the channel, welcome, come on in. And in case you're returning, thank you for joining me again today. And I hope that you guys are doing well. So for my Capricorn, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus individuals, when I was meditating over you guys' energy, the song that I got was As Long As You Love Me by Justin Bieber. Justin Bieber happens to be a Pisces, so you can be dealing with a Pisces, Sun, Moon, Rising, or Venus individual. You also got these placements in your chart as well. And you could have also started dating someone in Pisces season of this year, which is February, March time frame. Now, before I get into your reading, I do want to let you guys know that tomorrow I am doing a discount reading sale for September 9th. 9-9 discount reading sale. The sale will begin at 8 a.m. and it will wrap up at midnight, okay? I will post a reminder on the community section here on YouTube, also my TikTok and my Instagram. If you don't have that information, everything is in the description box below, okay? So, Capricorn, I'm going to go ahead and jump right into it because the message that I get with the song As Long As You Love Me, I feel like I'm getting like this person, some of you guys be dealing with someone who's codependent. And I also feel like you are literally the most stable thing, the most stable energy in this person's life. And I really get an energy of codependency. It's one thing to have compatibility and you guys balance each other, but I feel like this person leans on you. You are their rock. Literally, you are their rock. You are their anchor. Okay, but I'm getting a heavy energy of codependency. But I really do strongly feel like more than anything that something about this person is just erratic, like all over the place. Or if they're not like this all the time, they may have recently began to be like this. Like they're just all over the place. And it's like you're always having to pull them back or realign situations or balance things out for this individual. I'm keeping the energy of recklessness. Like with their behavior, getting in trouble at work, getting suspended from work, temperaments, something like that. And I'm talking about not children, but actual partner, okay? So let's see what we get for you guys today. We're going to go through the deck until we get your major arcana, which happens to be the devil. Then we'll get the card that comes before and the card that comes after. And we'll get clarifiers for those cards. Currently at the bottom of the deck, you have the Knight of Pentacles, the slowest moving knight in the whole entire deck of tarot. I immediately just heard right now, because you know knights are either going into battle, coming out of battle, okay? And they're going to battle for their country. They're going to battle for their, you know, for the, you know, to protect the king and queen in their kingdom and things like that. This is the slowest moving knight, so they're saying, like, you may not want to be so quick to keep jumping to their defense every single time. And that can be very hurtful, right? Because if this is someone that you love, it could be hurtful and it could be difficult to do. But they're telling you that you need to back up a little bit and let this person deal with their own shit. Not let it get out of control, but you need to let them deal with their own shit. Because if they keep creating shit storms, why should you have to keep coming in like permanent cleanup crew? I just get that you guys need to let them do their own thing. Again, not to their, you know, not to tear them down or anything like that, but literally you have to let them do some things and take care of some things on their own, because maybe then they'll realize how important and valuable you are. Because for some of you all, I feel like they don't see your value or worth either. You can be married to this person. Four of Wands. It could be a Leo, Sag, Aries. Doesn't have to be. We're going to go through the deck again. We're looking for your major arcana. There you go. Very quickly. Very quickly. So, again, I feel like this person always is relying on you to clean things up. And I'm hearing a damn song. I don't know who sings it. Leave it in the comment section below. I'm hearing a song, Clean Up Woman. It's a back in the day song, but I cannot think of who sings this. Like, right on the tip of my tongue, but I can't think. But I just heard that. I'm hearing the hook of the song, Clean Up Woman. So some of you are literally, this could be for a female that's constantly cleaning up behind your male or whoever, female partner, whatever you're into, it doesn't matter. I just feel like it could be a feminine that's doing this, okay? So right in front of you, you have the Ten of Cups. I feel like, you know, you can sit down and talk to this person and it can go harmoniously. You could be telling this person, like, you know, we need to work together. She has a thread that she's using to sew with. Someone's first, middle, last initial could be CGMW, TN, P, or S. There's your card. And then right behind your card, you have the Temperance card. So I feel like a lot of y'all are being very patient with this person. Or you've been very patient with this person for a long, long time. Okay? Could be dealing with Sagittarius. Remember, we stopped here with the Four of Wands at the bottom. So it could be a fire sign. You don't have to be married to this person, but it could be like you guys are living in a capacity where You know, it's almost like you're building a marriage where it feels like a marriage. I keep hearing clean up woman. I keep hearing that song. So, like I said, for a lot of y'all, you keep cleaning up this person's messes or this person's bad behavior. They're not learning nothing from it because you keep cleaning everything up. You keep making everything right. So, they're not learning anything. Bottom of the deck, you got the Six of Swords. And you see her head is drooping like she's not happy about it, but she's just going in whatever direction this person is sending her in. There could be a child or children involved here. Doesn't have to be. You could feel like this person is like a child to you. Like you have to do everything. Like this person wants to be the king or the queen of the castle, but they're acting like a child. Getting that also. So let's go ahead and part. Yeah, a child. I literally said a child. Pages for me are always the young, the youthful. They still got grown expanded to do. They're the young adults. They're the teenagers. They're the children. So this person could act like a child definitely on an emotional level. Because it comes to your emotions and feelings. So they can be emotionally immature. And that plays a big role in them making horrible decisions that affects your household. Because I feel like it affects the household because in the background, you got the house with the doors closed. So it's like with the door being closed, it makes me feel like it's not being addressed inside the house because they're sitting outside the house. You get what I'm saying? So yeah, you know what to do though. Major Arcana High Priestess, Piscean energy. Someone's first, middle, last initial could be BTJ. P-R-H-S. I don't know if I said W, but also W. Someone could be a Gemini rising. Doesn't have to be. Someone also could be a mass number 11 or a mass number 22. Bottom of the deck, Two of Wands. Yeah, this person keeps making bad decisions. Okay? Two of Wands need to choose a destination or direction to go in. In reverse, this person keeps making the wrong decision. They're going in the wrong direction all the time. It seems like constantly. Okay? I'm going to say again because they know that they got somebody who's going to have their back regardless of what they do. Definitely could be dealing with a fire sign. You got Sag here. Leo, Sag, Aries here with the Two of Wands. You got flames here surrounding you. So, yeah, you may feel the pressure also. Like, you may feel like something, something is time sensitive. Capricorn, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus. Something is time sensitive. Like, they didn't pay a bill on time. A fine on time. For some reason, I'm seeing like a traffic signal. You know how, like, if you get a traffic signal, run a red light or something like that, and there's a fine, you know how you get a certain amount of days. Also, tolls. Like, I know here in Illinois, we have like 7 to 14 days, depending on certain tolls or areas and things like that. Somebody needs to, like, you need to talk to your person about that, or that bill is going to go up for no good reason. Let's get a clarifying for the Ten of Cups. Okay, damn, that flew out. Came out sideways. You have the King of Wands, okay? So I'm going to say again, Leo, Sag, Aries, up right there in their power and their authority. In reverse, they are not sideways. This person is like, they're aware of what they're doing, but they're just not making good decisions, okay? Because upright is like, yeah, I'm on my shit. It's sideways. So this person is not making good decisions, which we picked up earlier. You have the Ten of Pentacles, and like I said, it's causing issues with the family. They're in that doorway. She's holding a pentacle. Some of you guys may need to take control over the finances because they're going to send you motherfuckers into ruin, okay? I didn't mean to call y'all motherfuckers, but for real. It's like they're going to send y'all into ruin because you are pentacles. And it's in reverse. They also could be costing, like, whatever they're doing is costly to the household. It's affecting the household on a financial level. And that's no good. Let's get a clarifying four. And you got a Ten of Cups here, and you got a Ten of Pentacles here, so something with October could stand out very strongly. You could be dealing with someone whose birthday is in October or something on the 10th. Okay? We have not came to that point yet. Something on the 10th, September 10th, may stand out. You may find some type of fine or fee or something like that. I'm like, what's happening? Why didn't you pay this? You know, something's going on here. And they're acting like they have control over everything, but they don't. They're not. They ain't taking care of it. They so used to you taking care of it. And I feel like they also may be like, oh, I told you about this or I told you about that. And they ain't told you nothing. You know? They're leaving you to balance everything. Because they're used to it. Let's get a clarifier for the Temperance card. Universal energies of light, love, and divine protection. Give me... Okay. So you got the Three of Swords. You can feel like overwhelmed and heartbroken and feel like, okay, you've been putting in a lot of hard work with your finances or various areas in your life, and it's like this person is just like shitting all over it. That's the best way I could say it. Definitely could be involving a fire sign, okay? So you have seven, so it could be a July Leo because it's wands. But also the seven wands, guardians, defensiveness, protection. Being defensive in reverse is the opposite. Now, it also could be like you're expecting this person to be defensive, but they're not as defensive as you would assume that they are. Because I feel like they get it. Because like I said, he's not completely reversed. He's sideways. So he knows that he's doing stuff. I feel like this person is just in a phase of their life where they're literally not paying attention to, they're not, you know, paying attention to details. Their antennas ain't up. It's just not the case. They may be going through something spiritually or emotionally. You know what I'm saying? Like when we go, and that's not to, you know, cover up for them, but when we go through spiritual things, our focus sometimes can be very tunnel visioned. We can have tunnel vision when we're going through spiritual things, and we forget this and we forget that and we forget that, because right now what's in front of us is more important. That's our focus, and everything else goes to the wayside, which is not good, but it happens to a lot of us, you know. So that's what this person could be going through. Also, with this Three of Swords here, some of you all, this situation has already ended because of this person's behavior like this. And I feel like if it has ended, you may have, you know, been ignoring this person, not talking to this person, not allowing this person to connect with you. But I feel like you will drop your guards. Like, if you got this person blocked, or you're telling yourself, like, absolutely not, I will not talk to this person, I'm done with it. I feel like you might hear this person out, especially if you have children with this person. Especially if you have children with this person, because I feel like you don't want to have a, you know, a broken family and things like that. But I feel like you're just exhausted, because that's what I'm getting exhaustion, tired of cleaning up this person's, you know, fixing and mending, because they're sewing. You're tired of mending this person's errors. You're tired of that. Now, always keep in mind, flip it and put it where it works for your situation. It also could be that this person says that they may come out and tell you, like, I'm tired of always being a clean up woman or clean up man. I'm tired of always having to mend ends when you do something fucked up. I just heard something foul. Somebody's doing something foul financially. Like, behind the scenes, they're spending money, and it's like big money too. Because remember, we had the Ten of Pentacles in reverse. Somebody's spending big money, and they're like expecting you to understand why they're spending that money. Okay, something going on here, but again, you're going to know about it. You're going to find out about it very soon. Because I do see something with the 10th, September 10th. I feel like something very significant is going to crop up in regards to either someone that you've ended things with. Because again, that Three of Swords could be like, this person is with you right now. Or something that with your current person, like if they were trying to hide it and block you from finding out, with this in reverse, you're going to find out. Okay? So, Capricorn, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus individuals, as always, I'm going to ask that you continue to like, share, subscribe. Don't forget about that 9/9 discount reading sale tomorrow that begins at 8 a.m., ends at midnight. The link will be in the description box below. Just click the Etsy link and it will take you there, and you can look through the options. And until next time, take care and be well. Bye.